Jan Swasthya Sahyog is a team of healthcare professionals who came together. They were trained in the best medical institutions of the country, and they resolved to work in the poor, rural hinterland to help improve the health and well-being of the people. JSS began its work in northern Chhattisgarh, in central India, in Bilaspur district, in the year 1999. Our aim was to get the technology, demystify the technology, and get it to use for poor people so that it can, you know, really function for them. We have, weighing scales which we have developed, and also infantometers and stadiometers which are portable, so they can be carried to the field. Jan Swasthya Sahyog has attempted to bring technology to the common people, demystifying it and adapting it to serve the needs of the rural poor. Say, for example, at the village level, the quality or the fitness of a source of water using the hydrogen sulfide based filter paper strip method. How to treat this water if this is found to be contaminated using an ultraviolet light based drum. An organic mosquito repellent oil that can help reduce vector-borne illnesses, especially malaria, dengue. And a sleeping bag with palm oil based heat source for newborns, especially those who are underweight, in order to keep them warm when they are discharged from hospitals. There are other technologies which can be used by the health workers and include a teaching stethoscope, an easy to read thermometer, a breath counter for diagnosing pneumonias in small infants, modular delivery kits which help to conduct safe deliveries at home and in small peripheral centers. Certain technologies that are very useful at the peripheral clinics include a first aid kit, an animal bite kit, also a hand washing station for villages where there is no piped water supply, and an easy to use spacer for administering nebulized drugs. So the purpose of the spacer is that it will hold the medication and you can breathe several times through the spacer while the medication gets in to the respiratory tract. We initiated a Phulwari program of village level creches, where currently 1100 children between the ages of 6 months to 3 years are cared for. A creche or a Phulwari worker is a lady from the same village who organizes this Phulwari, taking care of 10 children per worker.
As we go about our daily routines and busy schedules, I wonder how many of us are even able to imagine what it means to be poor and getting sick in rural India. It is this Bharat that was always Gandhiji's first priority. I believe we as a nation have failed to address the gross inequalities in access to basic health care and nutrition for the poorest in this country. And thus, I and my colleagues at JSS, Jan Swasthya Sahyog, that we called our organization, were fortunate to have been able to study science and medicine in some of the best institutions of the country, like AIIMS, CMC Vellore, and Tata Institute of Social Sciences. Would this knowledge be of any use to our less fortunate countrymen in rural India? This was the hypothesis we set out to test nearly two decades ago. Practicing medicine in low resource settings, what are the turnarounds required? First, despecialization, multi-skilling, and tasking and training other doctors in these was the job that we took on. Second, to train locally recruited personnel in nursing, laboratory, pharmacy, operation theaters, community health work, including the mid-level health workers. And third, to develop rational management protocols and a public health laboratory and a low-cost pharmacy to back this up, making even sophisticated surgical care within the reach of poor people. And finally, electronic medical record systems, which are geared more towards helping patient processes and treatment rather than hospital management and billing. We converted this into teleconsultations and tele-learning platforms in psychiatry, rheumatology, endocrinology, and other specialties in medicine. And also then got into developing such technologies which were low cost, demystified, accurate, and effective. I'm grateful to the Sri Jamnalal Bajaj Foundation for having conferred this prestigious honor on my organization, Jan Swasthya Sahyog. And I'm sure that this will be a long-term partnership that strengthens forces applying themselves to create a more just and equitable India. Thank you.